Okay, so introduce yourself and tell us about your business.
I'm Andy Galentine and my company is Whitley, and we analyze your personality from your social media profile based on your the words that you use and like your status updates on Facebook, your social demographics, how many likes you have, the kinds of things that you're interested in, what your friends, how many friends you have. And we do that so that companies can then use that information to compare people on compatibility. So if you were using a company like Airbnb, they could use it to say, okay, you have two offers for your couch for South by Southwest. This guy, he's a 90% match with you for a roommate. This guy's a 40% match. You're not gonna like the 40% match. You take the guy as a 90% match, you guys become good friends, you have a great experience, you reuse Airbnb again because you had such a great experience. So we're really supporting those C2C companies, helping them grow their business.
But you do go beyond the usual just likes and declared interest. So how do you do with everything that has to do with psychology of the people, etc.?
Yeah, we use a lot of the processing we do uses natural language processing. So we look at the kinds of words you use and how frequently you use them. Things like, do you use biological process words like eat or drink or sleep? Do you use cuss words a lot in your status updates? Is your grammar good? Do you abbreviate or use text language when you post? All of those things say things about your personality deep down inside. So when you use our app, you can try our sample app at wit.li and you can get a personality breakdown based on that.
And out of that, you extract my Mayor Briggs profile. So you know that I am ESTJ out of my Facebook profile?
Actually, we do it based on the big five personality traits, but yeah, we can tell whether you're an extrovert or an introvert. We can tell whether you're conscientious. We can tell if you're open to new experience or you're someone who likes to do something that you're comfortable with. We can tell whether you're a very flexible person or not, which I am not, and that comes out loud and clear. And we also do a sentiment analysis to understand whether you're basically a positive person or a negative person. And so we can track all of these traits and pull them out and then look at how you and I would get along. And that doesn't mean we're the same, it just means that we have compatible personality traits.
Who is using your app and what is your business model?
So we have an API that is publicly available. You can use up to 5,000 calls a day free. If you want to see an example of a company that's using it, check out ResumeUp. They're a dynamic resume builder. They've built it into their dynamic resume so that people can add components of their personality and how they work. So if they're very outgoing, very conscientious, that might be a good fit for the position that you have. And you can see that now on their resume. So if you want more information, you can check out our developer site.
And how are you going to make money?
Well, you get 5,000 calls a day for free through our API, but if you need more than that, that's where we have to talk about what you pay me. So
tell us a bit about, I'm glad to see there's a woman entrepreneur, at least one in Austin.
At least one. There's actually a few of us, but yeah, it's not. I don't run into many other women entrepreneurs here or anywhere, actually.
How is it to start up in Austin as compared to what we all hear about is like this Hollywood of startups called Silicon Valley?
So Austin is not, I definitely think that there are some advantages to being in the Bay Area for certain types of companies. Austin, though, has a, I would say, sort of second to Silicon Valley tech scene. We've got a ton of great developers here. It's a lot cheaper to work and live in Austin than it is in the Bay Area. So that's a lot going for it. And there are cheap flights. So if you need to be in San Francisco to meet with the VC, you can be there in a couple of hours, but you can live here and have a good quality of life.
So how many are you in your team? How long has it taken you to develop and have you raised money?
So we have not raised money yet. We are bootstrapping this off of, my co-founders and I have a previous company that we have run and we're actually still running. And we pay these bills out of that, so that we can grow this. We will probably be looking for funding in the next year. And we have about 14 people, but about half of them work on the legacy business.
Thank you.
Thank you.